is not real. The only place that fear can exist is in our thoughts of the future. It is a product of our imagination, causing us to fear things that do not at present and may not ever exist. That is near insanity, Katar. Now, do not misunderstand me. Danger is very real, but fear is a choice. We are all telling ourselves a story.
Good afternoon, guys. This is Giovanni from the Options Trading Channel. I hope you guys are having an awesome weekend, quarantined at your house. Yes, unfortunately, the coronavirus situation has hit my hometown as well, I'm sure, as everybody else's home. And we were not necessarily forced, but we were asked by our government and our governor and whatnot that all of our businesses around town operate at half the staff, half operation. They've closed down restaurants, they've closed down movie theaters and whatnot. And it's serious stuff, very serious stuff. Along with that comes fear. And I want to talk to you a little bit about my fear and my problems. My biggest problem as far as day trading goes, as a day trader, as an investor, it's fear. It's fear, guys, for many different reasons. Reasons that prohibit me to really sit at a computer and focus on my trading. I think that's more of the issue, more so than just losing or putting myself in a bad trade. It's fear that I can't watch my trades at work. Although I'm allowed to actually trade at work, I got permission from my supervisor. Things come up during the work day. The phone rings, clients call, guests call to make reservations and whatnot. And I force myself to get out of those trades, whether I'm winning or losing, likely for the most part, because I have a great strategy. I'm in a winning position and I sell out. And usually I don't end up selling out at my 10% gains. Should I just set my 10% gain or sell order at half of my position, usually most of the time it will get filled if I'm just patient enough, but I can't watch it. And that presents an issue within my trading world. Let me show you two trades that I placed that I haven't mentioned over the last week or so. I did place two winning trades, but let me explain to you those trades, why I got in, why I got out, and moving forward, I have sort of a plan, an idea. I have a big announcement to make later this week, earlier part of the week, maybe Tuesday, Wednesday. I will announce something big, something huge in my personal world, life, my career as well. So stay tuned with that. For the here and now, let me show you the two trades that I placed this past week that I haven't mentioned yet. So the first trade that I want to talk to you guys about is this QQQ puts trade. This is the very next trade after my VXX, the last known trade that you guys know about. I bought the 178 puts that expired in, at that time, I believe 9 days. I bought it at 11.75 and I sold it at 12.50, not quite 10%. I think 10% would have been a little over $13. I can't remember quickly, but let's take a look at that signal. This was traded on the 18th of March. Let's take a quick look at that signal here. Here we go. If you look at the middle chart, this is the 1 hour chart on the queues. If you look to the far right, that's the daily chart on the queues. And the far left, those are the intraday chart, the 1 minute chart of the puts that I traded. I got this signal right here, 2 hours into the market open. And at the start of the third hour, that's when we were supposed to get in, and look at that massive drop. I bought them at 11.75. I bought that one at 9.13 my time. That's this one right here, possibly. Yes. And I sold at 12.50 right there. They actually ended up going to $15.70. And that's what I'm talking about, guys. If I can just be patient, calm my nerves a little bit, but also the, you know, putting in the element of my day job, trying to trade during my day job, during work hours, not the best combination, but still nonetheless, I'm still allowed to day trade. So that's why I'm able to put in these small trades. But if I'm just patient enough, I put in my sell, my 10% sell order in, it'll be filled, and then hold the rest for bigger gains. But per the strategy, if you would have held on to it, if you didn't have any money management skills at all, you would have been at a losing trade here. You can see that it actually lost, because the way the strategy works is you get in, depending on what the last signal is on the daily chart. That's the only direction that the strategy will take. You enter as soon as it closes below that lower MOBO band, and then you exit after it closes above the upper MOBO band. So per the strategy, this was a bad losing trade, but with good money management skills, you could have squeezed out a huge percentage gain. Huge percentage gain. That's well over 20, 25, 30%. I can't do the math quickly in my head, but that's a huge win there. Let's take a look at the other trade that I made. That this was the Qs, I believe, on Friday. When was the 20th? The 20th, yes, was on Friday. I bought one at 1278 and sold it at 1331, even though I put in a limit order at 1320. So I get this signal on SPY after the second 1 hour candlestick close, and I got in at 1278, right at the beginning of the next candle here. I bet this was me, the top one. Yeah, right here. And it went sideways for a while, and then it made its move, and I ended up selling at 1330. This was probably me. Yep, this was me. And it went up 10% would have been 1405, and it obviously cleared that by a mile. Got up to the high 1511 in that run, and then it came back crashing down. I would have been selling the second half back at my original entry point at 1278. But I didn't. This was mainly the one that I was more sort of not really concentrated, not really focused. The phone was ringing, things were going crazy in the lodging industry because of the coronavirus. I want to show you, before I let you go, I want to show you this signal on the Qs that I was thinking about getting in while it was up here. It's not a bad idea. If you miss a signal here and it reverses back, if it's a bad signal, my risk to reward is better up here, right? Because it has sort of retraced a little bit, and then it made its ginormous move back down. If I remember correctly, the 180 call, or excuse me, the 180 puts were trading around $8 or so, and they ended up going up to, gosh, close to $15 or something of that nature. I can't remember. So moral of the story is fear. Fear is not real. Like you saw at the beginning of this video, fear is not real. The danger is, the danger of losing money is absolutely without a doubt real. But we choose to be fearful. We choose to fear the markets. And that's just the honest truth, guys. I need to prepare myself better. Like I said, I have a huge announcement in my personal and career sort of life world. I will announce that Tuesday or Wednesday what that is. Stay tuned, guys. I need to be better at controlling my emotions, controlling my fear, because it's a choice. It's a choice, guys. So before I let you go, just a quick recap. I will make a recap of all my trades since the start of the year, but for the year, the profit loss for the year is $841, and that's a little, you know, that's a little over 80%. Nothing to sneeze at, nothing to be extremely happy about, but I'm still happy that I'm in the green. I'm consistent more than anything else. If the only thing that I'm going to be proud of in my trading is that I'm consistently beating the markets, consistently profiting. I have very little bad trades. I think Since the beginning of the year, I only have 2 bad trades. I'll make a recap of all my trades in a later video, guys. So stay safe, everybody. Thank you so much for watching. I greatly appreciate the support. Comment down below what you think about my trading, my strategy that I'm using. What did you make money on? What did you lose money on? What do you need help with? I'm here to help, guys. See you here again on the next trading video. Hoping it's another green one, guys. You guys stay safe. Talk to you guys later.